present on the career and retirement of Jim Kearney in 5 minutes or less. A few important questions come to mind. Question number one, how many minutes beyond five can I get away with without risking the wrath of Casey? Because you know he's got a stopwatch going right now and he's thinking, get to the point, get to the point. Question number two, maybe I should just say no thanks and ask if Warren Smith would like to do the presentation. Question number three. How much vulgarity is too much vulgarity? A question that Jim has never asked himself. Question number four. Am I expected to be funny or worse? Clever? You know, like, wisecracking allusions to beer or Star Wars or beer. For anyone who was at Patty's last Saturday night, Tim Prosser and Gavin and Brendan Kearney kind of used up all the good jokes. So I guess I'm off the hook for the funny, clever bits. And the last question, is this an occasion to honor, congratulate, show respect and heartfelt appreciation? Or is this an opportunity to exact the revenge fantasy that I have been holding on to since 1984? Revenge it is. Picture mid-August. It's the second day of cross-country practice. I am a painfully innocent, insecure, 13-year-old freshman from the farmlands of Germantown, harboring a kind of illusion, expectation that my new teachers and coaches will be kind and nurturing as I navigate this new and discomforting experience that is high school. Enter 43-year-old Jim Kearney, the chilling voice, part nasal, part dagger, wearing only running shoes, a bandana, and the shortest of short shorts. Split all the way up the side. Way up the side, revealing way too much leg, way too much pride. There are 3 miles of color on these shorts. Kelly green on one hip, orange on the other hip, and unfortunately, white down the middle. Irish flag of terror. Please, Lord, do not let it rain. So we're doing a pre-run stretch at Jacobus Park, and he's dropping an absolute Tokyo-style firebombing and degradation on this poor senior. The kid had made an ill-advised comment about the flag shorts. The kid should have known better. All I want to do is survive, to stay firmly under the radar. All of August, my ragweed allergies were really bad that year. My interior nasal membranes irritated, absolutely volatile. And then it happens. It's a nightmare scenario. My nose starts to bleed. Heart. Panic. I've got the thing pinched. I've thrown my head back. But it doesn't matter. It just keeps humming. And some kid yells, "Mr. Kearney, that frosh's nose is bleeding." He walks over to me and takes a good look at me. Contingent of 70 shirtless boys forming a circle around their master. The park is silent. Jim sees the blood pooling in my hand and says, "Holy shit, this kid's gonna bleed to death." Because. So much success that everyone would forget the name of Jim Kearney within 2 years. Safe to say, Jim Kearney will be one of the most remembered individuals in the lives of thousands of Market High students. We all know he possesses a kind of Pied Piper quality, and I think we're all very lucky that he's chosen to use his powers for good, because if there's anyone that I know who has evil genius potential, it's Jim. I've often told his coaching colleagues who want to know his secret, I say, Jim can walk into a cross-country practice, 160 kids, and say, all right, today we're heading over to Washington Park. We're going to strip down to our short shorts. We're going to have a roll in that heap of broken glass and used syringes. Before he's even finished, 150 of those 160 kids are already disrobing. Get the hell with the other 10. If you're like me, you've probably thought, what kind of crack is he giving those kids? I think I finally figured it out, actually. Here's the secret. He is the most authentic person I have ever known. He is who he is, always, in every situation, in all company, at all times. With kids, with parents, with administrators, with his family, with his friends. He is deeply and genuinely honest to a fault. Most people want to be connected with that kind of authenticity. And what's more, it takes kids only a few days to see that their bravado is actually just kind of ironic. They feel and experience his kindness and his generosity of spirit. To say that Jim has spent 56 years teaching and coaching does not even come close to defining what he's been doing all this time. That would be like saying William Shakespeare wrote stuff. Sorry, like saying James Joyce wrote stuff. For the last 39 years at Market High, Jim has given nothing short of his best self. Every day in class, at practice, on trips, in private conversations with kids and with colleagues, for 39 years at Market High, Jim has changed lives. He has paved roads, he's inspired reflection, and offered his students the tools to consider a kind of collective human experience. I could keep listening. But let's narrow this down to one word. The only word we need to think fairly and precisely define what Jim has given to Marquette University High School for 39 years. That one word, without hyperbole, without reservation, is love. So although he's not here, please join me in saying, thank you, Jim, and we love you too.